Hello, everybody. I'm Preston Hawes. I'm one of the co-directors of the New England Youth Ensemble at Washington Adventist University. Now, I know we're small in number. Today, there was a bit of an advertising snafu, for which we apologize, but we do have a pretty wide viewing audience, so we're welcoming them as well. We will proceed with this program with the two first pieces, and then maybe just speak a little bit more about our programs, and continue on unannounced. So thank you all for coming. Really appreciate you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
C major symphony by Bizet was actually a piece that he wrote when he was a student. He was only 17 years old. He didn't actually intend to publish it. It was, as far as I understand, a school assignment. And it's underperformed, to be honest. It has so much vigor and youthfulness to it. It's one of those sort of effortless sounding pieces, the kind that Mendelssohn kind of wrote through his whole life. But Bizet, he was pretty young. He hadn't yet wrote Carmen, his most famous piece, which he wrote at the end of his life. But there's a sort of energy in this that followed throughout his compositional life. We will be playing the first, second, and fourth movement. If you want to catch the third movement, it will likely be featured in our Christmas concert on December... What? December 1st. Sorry. I have a lot of concerts around that time, so I'm getting them confused. December 1st. Put that in your calendar. We'll have a Christmas concert then. So, as I said, the first, second, and fourth movements of this symphony. I hope you enjoy it. Students have been working really, really hard on this. You'll notice the violins in particular have probably about 10 times the number of notes than anyone else in the orchestra. Unfortunately, violins, you know, I have to let you know, when you go into the professional world, you don't get paid per note. So you actually are the lowest paid of everybody if it comes down to notes. But it's fun to play anyway, so I hope you enjoy this.
Thank you. Thank you.
Brian Liu, and I will switch spots. I'll join the violins. And but before we do that, I do want to draw your attention to the program. There should be a little QR code. Do you see that? Yeah. So we found that during the pandemic, when we were doing virtual concerts, that people really liked these because you could just point your camera at it and then direct your full bank account to support the orchestra. It does cost a lot to put these concerts on and to give these students the educational experience that they need. I would also say that the Carnegie Scholars Program of the New England Youth Ensemble, along with the choirs, will be headed to Carnegie Hall on December 19th. We have a concert there that we're going to be performing with Mid-America Productions. And so if you have any interest in going up to New York to support us, we would love to have you in the audience. Just go to midamericaproductions.com and you'll see that. If you can't make it up there, but you'd like to help these students get up there, help pay the way, hotels, dinners, everything like that, your support would be greatly appreciated. So just point your phone at that QR code, send that QR code to your family and friends, people online, just spread it, make it viral, and the support will roll in. We so much appreciate your presence here and whatever support you can give. I will hand the microphone over to Brian Liu.
Thank you, Dr. Haas, and good evening. Our next piece is by the Taiwanese composer Kaxia Chen. I first heard her work last April at the Kennedy Center. The Taiwan Philharmonic was touring, and they premiered one of her works. And I'm like, oh, this is kind of cool. So I reached out to her. She's a professor of composition at the Curtis Institute of Music. And so the piece we're going to play this evening is titled Chasing the Sun, and these are just some of her thoughts on this. She talks about, you know, what inspires and nourishes a wandering heart. She said, when I ponder these questions, a childhood story told to me by my parents in Taiwan came to mind. Cao Fu is one of the earliest known myths in Chinese mythology. Cao Fu is a giant who wished to capture the sun. He was tall and strong, with two yellow snakes hanging from his ears. One day out of the blue, he became perplexed by the sun's whereabouts at night and decided to chase and try and catch the sun. With each stride, Cao Fu makes progress and slowly gets closer to the sun. He followed the sun from the east to the west, and as he closed in on the day star, all the rivers and lakes that crossed his path were drained and quenched to quench his burning thirst. In the end, the chase proved futile, and he died in his impossible quest, succumbing to extreme heat and exhaustion. Although Cao Fu failed, she says the story of his failed quest has inspired many people to be patient and not to overestimate their abilities when chasing their own imaginary selves. So this is Chasing the Sun by Kaxia Chen. This will be followed by one of my favorite pieces of all time, Romeo and Juliet. We all know the story of Romeo and Juliet, love, death, conflict, which you'll hear all throughout the overture. There's a fighting scene, there's the Friar Lawrence scene, there's a love theme, it will all come out. And so I hope you enjoy the rest of this afternoon's concert.
Thank you.
so much for coming. I also want to express our gratitude to our wonderful music chair, Dan Lau, who is here with us in the audience. He's created such a supportive environment for the Department of Music at Washington Adventist University. Once again, thank you all very much. Don't forget those QR codes, and we hope to see you at our Christmas concert December 1st. Thank you.